and a night at Eden Park like we've never seen before. Yes, the stadium's lit up, about to take over the lights, and in just under 20 minutes, Daniel Carter will begin his 24-hour Kickathon, raising money for the Pacific Islands and UNICEF. Let's get down to ground level now and join Matt Manukia live with Dan Carter. Matt.
Yes, Sam. Well, this morning when Dan Carter woke up, he said it felt like the morning of an All Blacks test, which is fitting because for every test point he scored as an All Black, he's going to match it by kicking a goal here. So that's 1,598 in the space of 24 hours. And he joins me now. Dan, thank you so much for your time. Why do you think the nerves have kicked in so hard today?
Oh, geez. Thanks for having me on the show, obviously. But I think it's just going into the unknown, like doing something that hasn't been done before, really testing my mind, also physically, doing something that I've never done before. So I think there's a lot of nervous energy, but a lot of excitement as well. And even when you look up on the screen and see the donations coming in, it just really inspires me to want to keep going.
Yeah, and I know you had a bit of a trial run in the lead up, picked up some injuries. So how have you sort of tweaked your approach for tonight?
I've had a few injuries in the build up, which is normal. It's a big part of my career. So I've worked out, I've got to kick off both feet. I've kind of worked out how hard to kick the ball. So I don't want to be kicking 100% every kick. I'll blow out. It's a little 50% strikes. A little recovery, make sure I keep refueling, got a good nutrition plan inside. So there's a few different strategies, but who knows, come the middle of the night, anything could happen. It's just about survival, really.
And you will be taking breaks, airing the feet, taking them out of the boots and into some jandals. The jandals are key.
Serious, 100%. Yeah, their feet need a little bit of air, and I've experienced that. I did a 6-hour kicking session last week and had blisters all over my feet. So you'll kick for about 40, 45 minutes and then take the boots off, give them a bit of air and refuel, and then chuck them back on and go again.
Yeah, obviously for a great cause. Tell us who will benefit from what you do here today, or tonight.
Yeah, it's really to give back to children in need, and some of the commercial partners have donated to the work that UNICEF are doing here in Aotearoa, and then 100% of the public donations for the Kickathon will go to a WASH program in the Pacific Islands. WASH stands for clean water, sanitation and hygiene, something that our children here take for granted. Providing clean water for kids in the Pacific is something that, you know, we're working towards tonight.
Yeah, well, it's great stuff. I would offer to chip in with a few kicks of my own, but knowing me, I'll probably break something here at the stadium. So I'll just wish you all the best, and we'll catch up with you a little bit later on. Thank you so much, Dan.
You. Appreciate it.
Sav, if anyone wants to watch, they can go to the UNICEF website. There's a live stream there. They can make their donations and also put in their requests for some trick shots.
There you go, Matt Manukia with the nervy Dan Carter live with us from Eden Park. We'll be back at the park tomorrow night as well.